Today on Matters of Fact, with at least 15 people killed just in July, Malacanang has warned that President Rodrigo Duterte might use his emergency powers to quell lawless violence in the Philippine province of Negros Oriental. But leftist groups suspect the president is just using the killings to justify a martial law declaration in the province later on. Joining us today is Brigadier General Bernard Banac, the spokesman of the Philippine National Police. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Christian.
And we're also joined on the line by Attorney Jacqueline De Guia, the spokeswoman of the Commission on Human Rights. Thank you very much, Attorney De Guia, for joining us this morning.
It's our pleasure, Christian. Good morning to you and to all our listeners.
Okay, I'll start with General Banac. Congratulations on your promotion, I think two weeks ago?
Last week.
Okay. Let's start with this latest warning from Malacanang that the president might use his emergency powers to quell what he called lawless violence. Now, is this even necessary? Because he already has that province under the coverage of Memorandum Order Number 32, which was specifically intended to quell lawless violence.
Well, Christian, the president has a wide range of options. He has executive powers, you know, insofar as peace and order is concerned. But at the moment, we'd like to assure the public that the situation in Negros is under control. And the police there is there, and then the security forces are there. And right now, we even sent an additional number of personnel to augment our PNP personnel there to maintain peace and order. And investigations are ongoing. And so there is no need to be alarmed or to be afraid. And the public may go on with their daily activities. And we assure the public that we are doing our best to maintain peace and order.
Now, if that is your assessment that the province or the situation in Negros Oriental now is under control, so why do you need emergency powers?
Well, what the president has announced or expressed is only a possibility. And we'll never know what may happen after this. But the assurance that we can give to the public is that we'll be there to maintain peace and order. And as I've said, there's a wide range of options available to the president if the situation goes out of control. But at the moment, we can say that the situation there is under control.
Okay. Attorney Jacqueline De Guia, good morning again for joining us. Now, I'd like to ask about that assessment by the Philippine National Police. General Banac is saying that the situation in Negros Oriental is under control. Now, based on the assessment of the Commission on Human Rights, is that indeed the case?
Well, Christian, we are heartened by the assurance of the Philippine National Police that the situation is under control. We do support the presence and the heightened visibility of the police as well as the military in the Visayas region, and particularly in the Negros province. And we do not see the need for the president to exercise any of his prerogatives. And we wouldn't want a declaration of a state of national emergency, nor a declaration of martial law in any part of the country, as what happened in Mindanao, because we fear that this will normalize martial law in a sense. And as the PNP has pointed out, in these circumstances, it is merely heightened police visibility and strengthened law enforcement that the province needs.
Now, there's also concern, Attorney De Guia, coming from human rights groups and leftist organizations that there might be a progression here, that the killings might be used actually by Malacanang or by the president to justify the declaration of martial law, when in fact, based on their accusations, it's the government or the state forces that are behind some, if not most, of the killings that took place in Negros Oriental.
Well, it's definitely a concern among human rights organizations that the situation might be used in order to justify another declaration of martial law or a state of national emergency in the province. And we wouldn't want that to happen. And we have not, at this point, excluded any possibility with regards to motives of the killing, and that is precisely the reason why we are conducting an investigation. However, we would like to point out that we do hope that the killings would stop. The killings has been a matter of grave concern for the commission, particularly because it has happened one after the other, and the brazenness is really something that we decry of and we wouldn't want to see happening again in the future.
Okay. General Banac, of course, that's your assessment. The situation is now under control, but it's still very alarming. At least 15 deaths just in July alone. Now, the suspicion is that most of the killings that came after the deaths or the torture by the New People's Army of the four policemen were actually in retaliation for what the NPA did.
Well, I agree with the Attorney De Guia. The killings has to stop, no? They must stop. And we're trying our best, really, to restore order in the province, and that is the reason why General Abayal, the Chief PNP himself, administratively relieved the provincial director to look into the possibility of some lapses, no, in his administration.
When you say lapses, what do you mean exactly?
The way they handled the situation from the beginning when the killings started.
Meaning what should they have done?
They could have conducted more visibility patrols, or they could have visited more areas, you know, just to check on the information of any armed men in the area. And all this part of the activities of the law enforcement to ensure that no killings would happen. And General Bayalde ordered for the relief of the provincial director to ensure that part of the activities that the PNP would like to do is to really restore order in the province.
But how likely is that is that angle, that the killings that came after the torture and the killing of the four policemen actually were in retaliation to that incident?
Well, we're still looking into this angle and possibility that reprisals, you know, revenge is taking place in the area, but all these have to be established through a thorough investigation. We have to base our assessment, our conclusion on evidences that we can gather, and so the investigation there is ongoing, and there are, of course, possible motives, like this could be insurgency related and politically motivated, or maybe due to land disputes. So all these we are looking into, and we're trying our best to really restore order in the area, and then assure our public that the people can live peacefully.
Okay, Attorney De Guia, so far what has the Commission on Human Rights found out when it comes to the killings that took place in Negros Oriental just in July alone? Were you able to identify certain patterns, or at least relations?
The commission already has launched our initial investigation, and we have been to the office to help our investigators in the office. Yes, because
Unfortunately, we're having problems with the line. Attorney De Guia will try to get her back on the line. But in the meantime, let's talk about the motives here. Because, again, it's not difficult to somehow raise that suspicion that reprisal actually took place after the torture and killing of the four policemen. Now, you mentioned that there were possible lapses on the part of the Negros Oriental police chief.
Yes.
Now, should that raise suspicion when it comes to those possible lapses after the killing? No. Meaning wala siya masyadong ginawa?
In a way, the former provincial director, Police Colonel Takaka, may have been negligent on some of his functions, so that all these killings took place. So this is now part of the probe that is going to be conducted by the national headquarters, and this is going to be led by the Directorate for Investigation and Detective Management under Police Major General Elmo Sarona to look into the possible lapses of the administration of Police Colonel Takaka and to look into why all these killings happened during his watch as the provincial director. And of course, just to make sure that there would be a fresh officer that would be handling the provincial, the province, leadership of the PNP deemed it necessary to install another officer there, an officer in charge in the name of Police Colonel Angelito Dumanging, who is the concurrent Deputy Regional Director for Operations of PRO 7.
So, siya muna in charge in the meantime?
He's the OIC, and he will look into the operations, the conduct of operations of the whole Negros Oriental Provincial Police Office. And he's tasked to really ensure that the order will be restored in the province.
Okay, Attorney De Guia is back on the line. So good morning again. Now going back to that question earlier, what has the Commission on Human Rights found out so far? Were you able to establish certain connections when it comes to the killings that took place in the province in July alone?
Christian, we have already started our investigation. In fact, the Commission on Human Rights have sent investigators from the central office as well as from the regional office to help our investigator in the sub-office because the sheer number of the killings that has become quite difficult for our investigators in the sub-office to investigate it solely on their own. Based on our initial investigation, we have already established contact with victims, team of the victims of some of the killings, particularly in the municipality of Ayumo, as well as our neighboring municipalities. And what has us was the brazenness of the attacks. And then have barged into some houses at the middle of the night, and most of them were masked. And we do note that some of those who have been killed, at least those who have we have contacted so far, appears to have been connected at one point to those who have been ambushed, those policemen who have been ambushed, and whose killings we have condemned in the strongest terms. And so these are the leads that we are pursuing right now. We are continuing our investigation. And Christian, I'd like to take this opportunity, of course, to request for the Philippine National Police to help and cooperate with the Commission on Human Rights in the conduct of this investigation. Because so far, again, our request for some reports have not been granted at the provincial level. And this is something that we would want for the Philippine National Police at least to settle, particularly because this does not, at this point, seem to pertain to the war on drugs or to the campaign against drugs. And we do hope that the non-cooperation will not spill over other cases as well.
Okay, so far, let me get that straight, because you're requesting the Philippine National Police to help facilitate the release of certain reports or documents that you are requesting. But so far, are they're not basically cooperating as you would have wanted them?
That's the initial report that we are getting from our team of investigators. And that is precisely the reason why we are requesting the cooperation of the PNP at this point. It is the interest of the PNP as well as the public at large to know the truth. And we share the same objective in finding out truth and putting a stop to these killings and seeking justice for the victims. And that is the reason why we, as part of the government, together with the PNP, would want to seek the cooperation of the PNP on this matter.
Okay, now that is a common concern usually. There's that complaint coming from the CHR and other human rights groups that the Philippine National Police is not exactly cooperating that much when it comes to investigations like this. How do you respond to that?
Well, in the past, we've had a very good relationship with the Commission on Human Rights. We had a very good cooperation, and in fact, we regularly conduct our own trainings with them.
But in this case, will you release the documents?
Well, it's just a matter of perhaps communication between the two agencies. And as we have said in the past, we are open to any cooperation with the Commission on Human Rights on a case-to-case basis. But insofar as the war on drugs is concerned, we know that this has to go through the Office of the Solicitor General.
Yeah, the usual.
An issue that has already gone political, you know. But in the case of in the Negros incident, of course the PNP is willing to cooperate with the Commission on Human Rights, and we are one with them to in our desire to look into these killings and really make the suspects and perpetrators really answerable before the law.
Now, what if the suspects are actually death squads connected with the police or the military? Because I'm asking about the impartiality of the ongoing investigation. The concern is that the Philippine National Police has basically cleared its own men. It's not the handiwork of the police. Now, you are investigating the killings. Now, some of the suspects or the groups are pointing to death squads coming from the police or the military. So how do you expect the investigation to be impartial?
Well, Christian, no one is above the law. If anybody of our colleagues, fellow police officers, or members of the security forces are found to be guilty, or they have committed evidence against them, their evidence is against them, then they need to be investigated, they need to be charged also, along with the other suspects, or like civilians. So what we're saying here is the investigation will be impartial. We look into all the angles and motives, including suspects, whether they are members of the police force or not. They have to be charged if there's evidence, and they need to be answerable before the law.
Okay. Attorney De Guia, how's the atmosphere in Negros Oriental based on the reports that you have been getting from your own people there in Negros Oriental? Because the assessment so far by the police is that the situation is under control. But when it comes to, let's say, possible witnesses, are you getting cooperation from them? Is there willingness to talk, or is there so much reluctance?
Well, Christian, I would have to say that there is a slight bit of fear in Negros right now. The presence of the police there tries to calm the situation, but with regard, of course, the kill of those who have been killed, there's no tangible, and most are reluctant to talk. And this is something that we would like to happen elsewhere. The fear that is spreading all over, and the hesitance to seek justice for their kin, and that is something that we hope through the past results of the investigation, it will be able to reassure people that the law enforcement is committed to making sure that the rule of law prevails in the province.
Okay, of course, the CHR is conducting an investigation into the killings of all those fatalities in July, including the four policemen who were tortured by the NPA?
That's true, Christian. We have condemned in the strongest terms the killing of the policemen, and we have said that whoever is responsible for those killings must be held to account. And we have launched an investigation also on those killings. And the cycle of violence that has happened after is something that we do not want to happen, and we decline. And that is the reason why we say that a prompt and thorough investigation and a swift holding to account of the people responsible will have to necessarily follow in order to put a stop to this cycle of killing. And it must be shown by the government, by the law enforcement, the rule of law should prevail, regardless of who is responsible. And again, the CHR is one with the government, that regardless of the identity of the perpetrators, whether state agent or non-state agent, both must be held to account if there are transgressions against the law.
Okay, that is the problem here, Colonel, Brigadier General Bernard Banac.
Yes.
So whoever the perpetrator is or the perpetrators are, it's the responsibility of the police to maintain peace and order. Now, let's go to the bigger context that in all likelihood, this is part of the insurgency, that it's a retaliation to what the NPA did. We know that Negros Oriental is infested by the New People's Army, that the killings might be part of this bigger context of insurgency. Now, how do you deal with that? Just to make sure that there's indeed peace and order.
Well, whether this is insurgency related or not, the fact that killings happened, crime has been committed, we need to investigate. We need to make the perpetrators, the suspects, you know, answer before the law. That is our job, that is our mandate. So,
are you getting cooperation from the people? Because if I heard it right, she mentioned the climate of fear, and that is understandable. We've also been hearing that from other sources. There's this fear coming from certain residents not to exactly cooperate because they might be, let's say, harmed, right, not just by the police, but also by the New People's Army.
Yes, we understand the feelings of the sentiments of the residents, the people in Negros. But this is the assurance that we can give them. We'll be there to maintain order. We'll make ourselves very visible. In fact, we have already increased our number of our checkpoint operations just to ensure that and assure the public that we are there, we are seen, we are visible to maintain order. And the people can go on with their lives, daily activities, and do business. So. That is the assurance we can give the people in Negros.
Now, yesterday we had former Anak Pawis Representative Ariel Casilao, who is a convener of the Defend Negros movement. Now, he raised suspicions regarding the so-called impartiality of the PNP investigation. His suggestion was to put up some sort of a truth commission. How do you respond to this?
Well, whether there would be another commission that will investigate, that would be outside already of the jurisdiction of the PNP, but insofar as our mandate is concerned, we are mandated to conduct investigation whenever there is crime committed or has been committed or is actually being committed. So that's why we are there. In fact, we have already launched the investigation and it is ongoing. And whenever a crime happens, then we have to investigate, and then if evidence warrants, we have to file the charges and make the suspects, perpetrators answerable before the law.
Okay, before we end, I'd like to ask Attorney Jackie De Guia, that suggestion of a truth commission, is that okay? Are you amenable to that, or somehow the existing mechanisms that we have now are enough to address this issue?
The need for impartiality is precisely the reason why the Commission on Human Rights has been created. We acknowledge the fact that human rights violations may be committed by state actors or non-state actors. And in the case that there is a probability that state actors are involved, we would want an independent body, such as the Commission on Human Rights, to conduct an investigation. And in this sense, we are conducting an objective and impartial investigation, and we do hope that with the cooperation that the PNP has committed to provide to us, we will be able to accomplish the same goals as a truth commission would do in this circumstance.
Okay, thank you very much, Attorney Jackie De Guia, and thank you very much, General Bernard Banac, for joining us today.
Thank you, Attorney De Guia.
Thank you. Thank you for watching. Now, for more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.